So let me tell you how my day's been.
Good morning, scripture of the day. Today we're looking for a hill worth dying on. It's about 4 a.m. Let's go.
We got in a car and we started driving, and we were not gonna stop until we found this, the hill worth dying on. We were ready to do whatever it takes. Drive wherever, hop a fence if we have to. We want to find the hill that's alive with the sound of Easter. I am so excited for us to celebrate Easter together as a church here at Compass HB after missing it last year when we couldn't gather together. Next week, we are going to celebrate the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus. The gospel is on the calendar, everybody, with Good Friday. And we're gonna have three services on Good Friday. The Hill Worth Dying On service, 3, 5, and 7. And I really hope you'll come early enough to make sure you get a seat in the auditorium for one of those services. And then for Easter, we're having 4 services. We've never had this many before, inside on Saturday night at 5, and then 3 outside on Sunday morning, starting with 7 a.m. sunrise service, and then the 9 and 11 o'clock services. So we are so hyped for this. We're like, we gotta get out there. We gotta film on the hill we're dying on. And so we went out there and we filmed the entire book of Joel that we're gonna read through together next week on Passion Week. That's how much we love reading the Bible with all of you. We're going through the book of the 12. We haven't even finished the first one, Hosea. That's what we're doing right now. But we already went out and filmed the whole second book, the book of Joel, because we're like, we gotta prepare for Easter. And we were out there on this hill, and this was the coldest and the wettest I think I've ever been filming scripture of the day. And I absolutely loved doing it because it is so encouraging to read the Bible with all of you. In fact, we're gonna celebrate it with Free Stuff Fridays this very day. Free Stuff Friday from 2 to 5 p.m. If you come by the church, we want to give you things for free. Now, we'd love to give you some trolley coffee if you come by. We will also give you the April Scripture of the Day calendar. We're going to read through 6 of the 12. We'll have Hosea, Joel, and then we'll go 6 more books in the month of April. This gives you the full and complete schedule. You'll also get the prophet's chart, and this will give you the context of every one of these 12 different books, where it is on the timeline, who exactly the prophet is speaking to. And we have a lot of surprises. We're just gonna be giving things away for free. When people walk up, we've got some items we're ready to give away, but the biggest one is this illuminated journal set that we will be giving to somebody who's been leaving comments on these videos throughout the week. We're gonna be just giving this to them when they come by church today from 2 to 5 p.m. And you'll see our The Hill Worth Dying On banner up there on our church. And it's just a great time for us to get together. And if you come by Free Stuff Friday, it's so encouraging to talk to you about what you're getting out of the book of Hosea. It really feels like we are in this together. And so I just want to thank you for reading the Bible. And when I was out there filming the book of Joel already, finding the hill worth dying on, because we want everybody to get excited about Good Friday and Easter. I mean, I got to tell you, this was uncomfortable. I mean, we were so far away from home. It was still so early in the morning. And I'm like, what are we doing out here? I mean, I'm in a stare down with some cows. I'm wondering if they're gonna stampede at any moment coming towards me. And I'm like, what is going on? And I look down and I see the dew on the grass. And immediately I thought about today's chapters from Hosea 12 to 14. As we come to the end of the first of the 12. Because maybe you remember the dew. God had said this about the people of Israel in Hosea 6:4, after they had kind of professed some kind of repentance that wasn't genuine. It was a fake revival. It was a false turnaround. It was 90 degrees, not really 180 degrees, turning around to the Lord. And God said to the people of Israel, your love is like the dew. And he meant by that, it's like here for a minute, and then it's gone. And when I was studying that, I thought, yeah, I don't really see the dew that often these days. And I did today. I was out there looking at this grass on this field, and I could see the drops of the dew. And instead of thinking about the Israelites' love that's like there for a minute and then gone, there's no follow through of obedience. I thought about God's love for us. That's really how the book of Hosea ends. I want to invite you to open Hosea and go with me all the way straight to Hosea 14, because it was really powerful how God flipped this dew analogy around in my mind, because it was such a picture of the lack of love, the unfaithful love from the Israelites to God. But then God now uses it in Hosea 14. He says this, and you got to see this verse with me in verse 5. He says, I will be like the dew to Israel. He shall blossom like the lily. He shall take root like the trees of Lebanon. His shoots shall spread out. His beauty shall be like the olive and his fragrance like Lebanon. They shall return. Like, this is going to be the real repentance. This is going to be the time when the people really turn to God here at the end of Hosea. And I just love how he flipped the dew around. Instead of it representing the fickleness of our love for God, it represented the life-giving power of his love for us. And that dew is watering the earth and giving life. And so reading the book of Hosea has really been a strong reminder of how strong God's love for us really is. That God has taken the initiative to love us, and then even when we are unfaithful in our hearts towards God, his love remains steadfast for us. And if you want to just go through these chapters with me, in Hosea chapter 12, it really reminded me where the nation of Israel gets its name. And remember that it's called the nation Israel because Jacob was given the name Israel. And in Hosea 12, it goes back to Jacob. And it says, he will punish Jacob according to his ways in verse 2. And then you realize there in Hosea 12 at the beginning, it's actually talking about Jacob the patriarch, like Abraham, Isaac, and then Jacob, Israel the man, before it was Israel the nation. And it talks about taking you back to Genesis 28:11. That would be a great cross-reference to go back to the story, where he has an encounter with God at Bethel. This is what started everything for Israel. And it says in verse 6, Hosea 12, 6, so you, by the help of your God, return. Hold fast to love and justice and wait continually for your God. Do you remember the encounter that Jacob had with God at Bethel? Okay, well then you should turn to God. And you should hold fast to his love and justice, because that's who God is. And you should wait on the Lord. See, waiting on the Lord is not passive. It's an active faith in the Lord. It's knowing he's going to come through. It's looking for him to come and meet you in the present as you wait for him. And so I loved how it was taking Israel back to its roots, so to speak, back to the man Israel and his relationship with God, to then call the nation Israel to turn and have a relationship with God. So we've seen shuv has really been a theme throughout the book of Hosea. The theme is the love and how the Israelites are turning away from God and not loving him, but God is so steadfast in his love, he is going to turn Israel around to him. And so you get the call again to repent in chapter 12, and then in chapter 14, you get the sense that they really do repent. And in chapter 14, verse 1, it says, shuv, O Israel, turn, O Israel, to the Lord your God. For you have stumbled because of your iniquity. Take with you words. I love that. Like, you can't just have this idea of repentance. You got to go and talk to God. You got to go and confess your sin. You got to go and ask him to change you, to turn you around, to empower you, to not keep going down the same iniquities. You got to say to him, take away all iniquity. I love that. When we're going to confess, when we're going to repent, take with you words when you go into the presence of God. And really talk to him about your sin. Get real with God when you turn to him. And then it says, and this is just an amazing verse. If you don't know this verse, Hosea 14, verse 4. Hey, let's blast this on social media today. Let's send this to some friends of ours today. Let's make this verse known. among our church family of Compass HB on this very day. I can't wait maybe to see some of you at Free Stuff Friday later and share this verse with you. This is Hosea 14, verse 4, where God says, I will heal their apostasy. I will love them freely, for my anger has turned from them. And that's when he drops, I'll be the dew to you. Since you guys are like dew to me, where you're just there for a moment and then gone in your love, no, I'll be the dew to Israel and I'll give life. But in verse 4, let's just think about those three lines. I will heal their apostasy. The word that's translated apostasy, it's like a form of shuv. It's like, I will heal their turning away. They keep turning away, I'm gonna have to come and heal them. I'm gonna be the one to grant them repentance. They will keep turning away unless I come and heal them. So he's going to stop them from turning away by giving them his healing. And then he says, I'm going to love them freely. Like, what an amazing thing that God's love is not reciprocal. God's love is not based on how we are to him. He is free to love us in his steadfast way through his son, Jesus Christ. I mean, that's just powerful. God is free to love us no matter how we love him. This is how he's going to love us. And then he says, for my anger has turned from them. Like, God's going to heal them from turning away, and he's going to turn his anger away from them. Like, God's going to shuv. God's going to turn away his anger, love them freely, and heal them from their turning away. In the end, God will have a love relationship with his people, Israel. It starts out with a prophet and a prostitute. In chapter 11, it was a father who was so sad about how his son that he had called out of Egypt had not followed him, which was ultimately fulfilled by Jesus. And now at the end of Hosea, it's going to be a God with his people. And he will love them freely, and he will turn away his anger from them. He will turn them away from turning away, and they will have a relationship. God in Israel, God in all of his people. So Hosea is a profound and powerful prophecy of the love of God for his unfaithful people. And so I hope you've been stirred up in your soul. And I hope that that'll just get you thinking, you know, how has God loved me? The main way is while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Even when we were ungodly, even when we were his enemies, he loved us to send his one and only son. And we're going to be celebrating that together, Lord willing, soon and very soon. So there is a lot of hype here for our upcoming Easter celebration, the hill worth dying on. And I look forward to seeing you for more here on Scripture of the Day.